Okay, hello guys. Today we are gonna see a project on Eastern Information System, which I have made with Java on NetBeans using Java Swing. And for the database, we have used SQL Server Database Management District. Let me show you. So this is the SQL Server, and this is my database for the project. We can see there are a few tables. I have used all of them to fetch data and insert data using Java Swing. So I expect you to know about SQL Server or SQL Server and know about database, how it works and how to store data, how to run queries and all that. So in case if you don't know about it, you can learn it first. One thing, important thing is you have to make sure that you are logged in as SQL or SQL authentication server. So in case you don't know about that, I'll leave a link in the description, or you can create your user account. You can so that we can log into as a SQL server authentication mode. So now let's go to our user interface. So this is what the front page looks like, the home page looks like. So we can log in. So you have two options: login for admin and student. And about us is about information about me and my friends and the feedback. So I'm going to start with feedback. So you can leave your thoughts here and just using your email. So first thing first, we're gonna see how we can register into the system. So this option where admin and student both can register itself, herself or himself. So let's register as student. So I have to provide some information, just like so I'm providing some information. So password I like, and the class role, let's say okay, now I'll provide the phone number. The address, whatever. So if you just click on this register, it's gonna register. Okay. So it's showing a message that you have successfully registered. So now for the admin part, it's gonna work the same as let me show you again. So whatever, so just click on register, it's gonna create account for admin or student, whatever you want. So now from this page, we can move on to logging. Otherwise you can just go back and we can go into login. So in a login, there's two options. Either you can log in as a student or log in as an admin. So let's log in as an admin first. So it's gonna take us to the admin dashboard. So first we're gonna have a look at admin dashboard, then we're gonna look at student dashboard, how student dashboard looks like. So if you are in this page, so you can, from this page you can go into register page and train an account as well. So let's click on login, and it's showing that we have logged in successfully. So this is the administrator dashboard or admin dashboard looks like. So here, so any information that are stored in this database or the system, so we can use we can search them using a ID or using ID, which is I have used as primary key. So let's enter and click on search. So it's gonna show some all the information about that student. So in case the ID username or ID you're searching for is not in the database, it's gonna show nothing, and that's important. So here I'm searching with 20. 20 is doesn't exist in the system, in the database. It's gonna show now. So we're searching with one, it's gonna show all the information about him. Let's go back, and so from student can either register herself or himself, or admin can add students or edit students and update students, delete or anything she admin wants. So we can update anything. You can just click on, so as I've told you that we have registered at this Tini, and Tini has been stored in the database and showing here in this table. So if you just click on here, so any of them, we can delete them. We can just click on here and click delete. It's gonna delete that from the database. Just click here, we can, let's update the address. So it's gonna say Taka. So it's gonna update the city of this column is at Taka. Let's click on it, update, and the city is our address is updated as Taka. So we can either, we can also add a student. Let's go back and click on. So you can also add a student here. So I haven't stored any information, haven't put any of the data, any of the data fields. So it's gonna show null, and these are your buttons, and these are already selected. So this information is stored. So we can also update anything from here. So let's say anything, name, just anything for saving time. So make sure the we can add them, it's been added. So that's how it works. And the other features we have here is this two button is also take you the same page as I have shown you earlier, and this is well. So we can add routine for students. So let's say section B Sunday DBMS sessional room number author, and we can assign, and it shows that routine has been successfully added. So, and we have added this routine at the moment right now. So we can, if you want, we can edit them. We can say DBM sessional, we can update them. So it's gonna show DBM sessional, and that's how it works. We can also delete them. Just click and select the row and click on delete, and this has been successfully deleted. It is no longer available, number 32. So that's how it works. And the next, we can do course registration. So you can select the semester and select ID. So let's say 30. So shit, let's go back and come in again. So let's say ID is 30. So make sure the ID is you're using is already in the database. It is now stored in the database, and it's gonna show error. So just leave them as it is for making this video short. It's like carriages 3 section. So A, cheers, Mr. So anything name, Mr. X. Let's click on register. So it's gonna register. You can see here we have registered this, and we can also edit it. Let's say name the change the name of this teacher. Let's say Dave Morrison. So update, and it is updated successfully. So you can also delete it from here. So this is deleted, so no longer here. Sorry, let's delete it. It's no longer exists. So let's go back, and we can add results for the student. Well, let's say ID is 30, and the semester is 8, and the CGPA is, let's say, 3.90. So enter, it shows the successfully added. You can see that 30 semester rate and CGPA is 3.90. So I can go back and see, and the last and final option here, you can see the live result here. So we can add live result for any student. Let's say this is the semester spring 19 and the ID is 30, and click on here. So sorry, there is no registration for this ID. Just click on. So you have to use an ID which for which course session is already done, and just click on here, and all the courses that has been registered to for the ID 1 is showing this table. So you can just select the course ID. Let's see, CD 231. Oh, sorry. 3 to 1, and just click on here. Sorry, select something like this. Yeah, 133, and click here. So it's going to show the course name. So in the previous, okay, it's gonna show the course name, and you can enter the marks of the quiz, and you can also add the mark of the midterm, and also mark of the midterm improvement, and submit it. So all we have done here, we can show it, we can see it, or a student can see it in this, in his dashboard. So now we have done with this admin dashboard, and now we're gonna move on to the student dashboard. So just so login as student, and so enter a valid username and password. Okay, so here we go. So is it wrong or song here? So the mistake, okay. We are logged in successfully. This is the student dashboard to look like. So that routine has been added by the admin. We can see from here. We can select our section and search. We can see routine. Yeah, that we can not edit it. We can delete it. We just can see it. And the course registration, we can just select the semester and ID, and we can see the course registration. Or we can neither edit it or delete it. So we can just see what course we have been registered into. Just we can go to different ID. So if you enter an ID that has not, that does exist in the database but not been assigned, or any course that our course session is not done for this ID, it's gonna show nothing. So let's say 30 that exist in the database but not course session has not done for this ID. For this, select actually shows now for this semester the course session is not done for this ID. And but if you select the previous semester, in that semester course session it has been done, and it's gonna show the result. So the next we have semester result. We can search semester result and select any semester we like, and we can get it, get the result we want. Now the last thing we have in this project is lab result, and it almost looks like the same as in the admin dashboard. So whatever result is added by the admin, we can see it from here. So it looks like the same. And I'll click on select any of the course ID. Three to one. So it doesn't show any results here. It should show a course title of the of this course code, but it doesn't show that because I have not, or admin have not added any live result or any result for this course. And if we select a different semester for which result has been added, it's gonna work. So just select on here and it's gonna show some courses, and just select CSE 221 and click here. So it doesn't show, that means no result is added for this. So let's say traversy this one. Oh yeah, result is added for here. No result is still no result added. So let's try a different one. So, well, in this case, result is added for this course. Let's try a different course. CSE 221, and click no result added. And this is so ridiculous, man. 2-4, no result added. So. Let's see. So finally, we have found a course which result has been added by the admin. So for this course, CSE 224, electrical circuit and devices. So the result is added. So yeah, that's pretty much the project is. And just log out from this student dashboard, and it's about us, some information about me and my friends. And so show, as I've seen, shown you the start of the project. So you can leave your thoughts about the project, drawbacks and etc. And just drop your email and submit. So let's just show you something. And everything is done with this project on using Java Swing. And every data we inserted, every data we fetched is from these databases. And so I'm gonna show you an example. We have registered student as Dini, and just edit, just click on the table and edit 200 rows so we can show the information here. Look at this. This is the information we added, and this is also, we also added this. So all of this information that is stored and fetched is from these databases, tables, and this is very important. You have to learn this very carefully, and this is the beauty of the computer science to understand all this. If you just do present, you can feel so good and so interesting if you find interest in it. So I hope you enjoyed it, and this will be helpful. I will leave all the links necessary for this video in the description, and all the source code and all those videos that you should learn, or you need to understand this project. And I hope you are all having a good day, and thank you, goodbye.